गुड मॉर्निंग, आवाज येतोय माझा?
यस मॅम.
ओके. So in last lectures we have started with the Kali group of remedies. So we have seen the main characteristic of the Kali group, and also we have seen about Kali moor. Today we'll start with the Kali phosphoricum. So common name is phosphate of potassium. The name itself suggests Kali is a potassium and phosphoricum is the phosphorus. So common name is the phosphate of potassium. Its formula is K2HPO4 and prover is Dr. H.C. Allen. Even it is proved by Dr. H.C. Allen, it is the one of the best 12 tissue remedy which were proved by Dr. Schussler. So this is one of the organic tissue salt which is introduced by Dr. Schussler. This medicine has proved by several authorities from time to time, but proving by provers of Union of Chicago under the direction of H.C. Allen is notable. And it contains the phosphorus elements. It is the greatest nerve remedy. So Kaliphos is a nerve remedy. It mainly acts on nerves. Its sphere of action. The main action of this drug is on animal fluids and tissues, mainly on brain, nerves, muscles, and blood cells. So its action is on brain, nerves, muscles, and blood cells. Pathogenesis. As Kaliphos acts upon the brain and nerve cells, upon the corpuscles of blood, affecting the nutrition, it causes irritation. And this irritation is followed by inflammation and lastly to the degeneration. So Kaliphos acts on brain, nerves, blood corpuscles. It affects the nutrition and causes irritation. And irritation is followed by inflammation and lastly to the degeneration. But degeneration is a moderate degree. It is not a syphilitic remedy, so it causes only moderate degree of degeneration. Clinically, it is indicated in anemia, asthma, brain fag, carbuncle, chilblains, dysentery, enuresis, gangrene, hysteria, insomnia, melancholia, neurasthenia, paralysis, and purpural mania. So many clinical diseases. Anemia, asthma, brain fag means tiredness of the brain, fatigue of the brain. Patient cannot think anything. Carbuncle, chilblains. Chilblains, these are skin conditions caused due to excessive cold. Dysentery, enuresis. That is, cannot control the urine. Gangrene, hysteria, insomnia, sleeplessness, melancholia means negative thinking, nervousness, neurasthenia means they cannot have the sense of pain as it acts on the nerves, neurasthenia, paralysis, and purpural mania. Purpural mania, purpural is, purpuram period is a 45 days period after delivery. So puerperal mania and psychosis during puerperal period. And constitution, physical makeup. These are mainly anemic person, chlorotic person, chlorosis. Chlorosis is the old terminology used for the anemia. So anemic, chlorotic, delicate persons, which are worn out from long sufferings. Temperament, this Kaliphos has a nervous temperament. Thermally, these are chilly patients, and miasm is a sore miasm. Elements from grief, sexual excitement which is indulged or suppressed, causation due to mechanical injuries, causation due to blows. Then mind, they are very nervous. Then the depression of spirit, general irritability. As it has nervous temperament, so mainly nervous peoples, anxious peoples. There is a great despondency about business. There is a loss of memory, indisposition to meet people. They don't like to talk with people, even with family also. There is a shyness, disinclined to converse. There is a want of energy, worn out persons. They want energy. The slightest labor seems a very heavy task. There's a brain fag from overwork. They feel that their brain is fatigued. There's anxiety, nervous, dread, lethargy, gloomy moods, fancies. The looks on dark side of everything, negative thinking, melancholia. There's a negative thinking, nervousness, night terrors with somnambulism. Somnambulism is walking in the sleep. There's extreme lassitude and depression. Hallucinations and illusions of senses. They hear some noises or see something. They fly into a passion and can hardly articulate. There's an aversion to answering the questions. Indifference is there. There's apprehensive anxiety, usually in the evening, in the bed, during night, anxiety after eating, anxiety about future, anxiety about his health. She's very cruel to her baby and husband. She's very indifferent, perverted affections. She broods over her conditions. There's an aversion to company. She wants to be alone. Complaints come from bad news. Like other remedies, complaints from bad news is Epis, Ignatia, Natrum Moor. There's a confusion of mind, low form of delirium, means they talks continuously talking, delirium, usually in typhoid and septic fever. There's imaginations, hallucinations. She sees dead people, sees figures, frightful images. She is discontented. Discontented means unsatisfied. So discontented and sad. He is very excitable, greatly wrought up from bad news. Then follows palpitations and many nervous symptoms. So elements from bad news. There's exhaustion after exertion of mind. There's a fear usually in the evening, fear of crowd, fear of death, fear of disease, fear of evil, fear of people, and fear of solitude also. Solitude means loneliness. Even if they want to be live alone, but they are having fear of being alone. He is easily frightened, and this fright increases many nervous symptoms and mental symptoms. There is a weak memory, forgetfulness, cannot recall words. Very good remedy for homesickness. Other remedy for homesickness is the phosphorus. Causation due to effects of grief, prolonged sorrow. There's indifference to surrounding, indifference to joy, indifference to her family, indifference to his business matters. And after indifference, there's indolence and lassitude. Any important keynotes? Conditions which are arising from want of nerve power, neurasthenia, mental and physical depressions. These are important keynotes. As it acts on nerves, there is a symptoms due to want of nerve power, neurasthenia, sensationless. It corresponds to states of eudaimonia. Eudaimonia is loss of energy. No energy is there. Dynamic. Since the dynamic means energy, power. So there is a loss of power, loss of energy. So state of eudaimonia, decaying conditions, gangrenous conditions. There is a great prostrations runs through this remedy. The discharges are very offensive and putrid. There's a headache, usually of students or those who are worn out by fatigue. Usually right-sided neuralgia, which is relieved by cold applications. So right-sided neuralgia relieved by cold applications. Tongue is coated brownish like mustard color. So mustard color coating over the tongue. Tongue is excessively dry in the morning. There is a nervous gone sensation in the pit of the stomach. Nervous sensation in the stomach. Diarrhea is foul, putrid odor, offensive. Diarrhea is caused due to fright with depression and exhaustion. Menses are too late or too scanty in pale, irritable, sensitive, lachrymose females. Lachrymose females means who cries continuously, crying. Or sadness. In sleep, there is a sleeplessness after worry or after excitement also, or due to nervous causes. There is a somnambulism. Somnambulism is walking in the sleep, usually in the children's. In head, there is a giddiness when they are out of doors. Aggravation when facing sun. So giddiness due to sun exposure. Seasickness without nausea. There is a vertigo with pressure on the brain. Occipital headache which lasting all night. Frequent waking with pain and better on rising. They woke up with pains in occiput and loins, and which is better by lying on back, and the pain passed off after rising. There's a dull headache across the eyes, which is better at outdoors, aggravation in the left side, left eyelids, droops with headache. Before menses, there is a violent tearing pain in the forehead with sense of fatigue. So fatigue is the main keynote, fatigue, neurasthenia. So before menses, there is a violent tearing pain in the forehead with sense of fatigue, and which is better by lying down and on menses appearing. There's a pain through base of the brain from eyes to occiput. We have seen the pain from occiput to eyes. In which remedy? It is in cilicia, occiput to eye. And here the pain travels from eye to occiput. Aggravation in the night, better by eating and gentle motion. Other remedy which is better by gentle motion, it is a sepia. There is a burning pain in the forehead, especially during stools. Intense headache from emotions and physical effort. Headache in the morning on awaking with vomiting of sour phlegm, making eyes unable to bear light. There's a pain across the forehead and into the both temples. Neuralgic pain at the base of brain and upper spine. As it acts on nerves, its important symptom is a pain. Either it is an intense pain or painlessness. So both sides. There's a sensation of band around the forehead, just above the eyes. There's a heavy, dull pain over the eyes as if brain would expand, but for cranial bones. There's a sharp darting pain over the left orbit, intense itching on the scalp, which is aggravated in the morning after waking. Soreness in the back of the head, which is aggravated by pressure. Back of the head is a sore as if hairs being pulled or as if hair pins are sticking in the head. There is a neuralgia of a left mastoid process, which is aggravated by motion and in the open air. There's itching of the scalp or used in a baldness and scalp is dry. Then eye complaints. The conjunctiva is inflamed. There's a watery secretion from the eyes. There's a sensation of sticks in the eyes, sensation of sand in the eyes, dryness of the eyes, burning pain, pricking sensation, smarting sensation in the eyes. The eyes are full of mucus, which are aggravated in the evening. The lids are swollen, agglutinated in the morning. Sty on the left lower lid. Left lid drops and almost closed, which is ptosis. So used in a condition of ptosis, but left-sided ptosis. We have the remedies for right-sided ptosis also, like staphysaglia, euphorasia. There's a sharp pain from eyes to temples in the morning, which is better by pressing on the temples. The eyes feel sore around the edges of the lids and burns through, they had been full of smoke. The eyes are sore as if crying hard. They awoke with severe pain through the left eye. There's an intolerance of light with headache. Eyes are tired with reading. There are black spots moving before the eyes. In ears, There's a itching and pimples in the canal and external ears. There's a deep-seated pain in the ears with stinging pain, itching in the ears, and aggravation by lying down. There are sharp pains in the left ear and down to the left cheek. Hearing is too sensitive, cannot endure the noise. In nose, the nostrils are stopped, discharges of clear stringy mucus, obstruction, sneezes on slightest exposure to the air, usually in the 2 a.m., fluent watery coryza, violent sneezing with symptoms of fresh cold. So we can use this remedy in allergic rhinitis. There are sores inside the nails with yellow crust and dark blood. Symptoms of the cold with headache, soft green or white discharge, small growth, very sensitive at opening of the left nostrils, which lasted usually for 2 weeks. Very sensitive to the smell, and sometimes there is a lack of smell. In face, there is a itching under the ear or to the right cheek and temples, itching pimples on forehead and suppurating on next day, neuralgic stitches, especially from upper teeth to the left ear, from temples forward to a point just above the right eye, which is aggravated from cold air and better by warmth of the hand. There are pimples, sore crust on lips, peeling of the lips, soreness and swelling of parotids and axillary glands, red hot burning face and forehead. At other times it is pale and yellow, sickly pale, dirty complexion of these pupils. There is a pain in the jaw bones with stinging and aching, which is better after eating, speaking, walking, and by touch. In teeth, teeth feel sore, severe pains in the deep of filled teeth, the surroundings, gums much swollen. Pain in the teeth after every cold, aching in the teeth with much secretions of saliva, grinding of the teeth, there is a mumbling in the sleep, detox in the sleep, grinding of the teeth during sleep. There is a swelling of gums and upper lip, aching of the teeth all night and forenoon. Gums feel swollen, soft, bleeds easily, dull frontal headache and nausea with dizziness, which is alternating with toothache. In mouth, there is a left submaxillary gland swollen and sensitive. So Kalyphos is a left-sided remedy. All complaints are on left side. Offensive odor from the mouth, mainly in the morning, like a rotten cheese. The tongue is white, slimy, greenish yellow, mustard-like covering on the tongue. The upper surface of the tongue is stiff. The edges are red and sore, red edges and transverse cracks on the tongue. Roof of the mouth is swollen in ridges, feels though lined with a grease. Saliva is profuse, thick and salty. The mouth tastes badly. There is a bitter taste in the morning, putrid, bitter and sour taste. In throat, tonsils are large, especially left side. There is a dry sensation in the throat as if from husk of grain. So dryness is marked in the throat. In morning, both tonsils have a distinct white solid deposits like diphtheric membranes. There are traces on it on pillars of fossils. There's a severe shooting pain from left tonsil to the inner ear while driving in the forenoon. There's a severe pain in the right tonsils also, which is aggravated by swallowing. There's a soreness, fullness sensation, burning soreness, dryness, which is aggravated mainly in the evening. There's a mucus in the throat, which is much after rising, which causes nausea and which is salty in taste. In stomach, there's a nausea after eating, and after that there's a drowsiness. There's a belching, smelling of sour and bitter food and blood, vomiting of a blood and with palpitation of the heart. There's eruptions of bile, which is aggravated after eating. There is a nausea, which is better by belching. Stool and anus. The stools are clay-colored stools, watery stools, with urging, putrid, offensive flatus, which is followed by tenesmus, which is after breakfast. Tenesmus is a pain in the stomach, cramps in the stomach. Light-colored stools, offensive, unsatisfactory stools, place offensive, which is before 6 a.m. Offensive, undigested, dark colored stools, which is aggravated after breakfast, after dinner. So diarrhea while eating. In constipation, the stools are dark brown colored, streaked with yellowish green mucus. There's aching in the shoulders and arms, better by motion, better in the evening. Hemorrhoids are protruding with swelling and burning pains. Then in respiratory, cough from irritation in the trachea, just below the larynx, with scanty, thick white mucus, yellowish expectorations, sometimes without expectoration. Cough is aggravated in the 2 to 2:30 a.m., so in the midnight. Sudden unexpected spells preceded by pressure in the throat. There's a hoarseness, trachea feels hurt. There's a rattling or whistling cough where there's expectorations are green like soap suits. Sputa is like salt, fetid or sweet in taste. Yellowish color sputa in thyroid. Thyroid is old terminology for tuberculosis. Then in neck and back, stiff neck from swelling of the glands. Neck is lame, tender to touch. There's aching between scapulae. Stitching pain, which is severe in the middle of the back towards the front of chest with dyspnea, and which is better by leaning against something. Aggravated by lying on back, sitting or walking. They wake up with pains in occiput and loins, which is better by lying on back, and which is passed off after rising. There's a creeping sensation and intense pain along the spine, relieving the headache at intervals. Back is lame as from a fall, sore from shoulders down. In male, there's a nocturnal emissions, sexual power is diminished. Impotence and painful emissions at night without erections. There's utter prostration and weak vision after coitus. In females, menses are too late or too scanty. in pale, irritable, sensitive, lacrimose females, irregular, scanty, almost black colored menses, offensive odor, amenorrhea with depression of spirits, lassitude and nervous debility, leucorrhea is yellowish, scalding and which is acrid, acidic. Inhibitory organs, very yellow urine, there is incontinence of urine from nervous debility, there is enuresis, cannot control the urine, paretic conditions of the bladder, there is a bleeding from the urethra. Modalities, there is aggravation by excitement, worry, mental and physical exertion, aggravation in the early morning, amelioration by warmth, by rest, and better by nourishments. So Kaliphos is the main remedy which acts on the nerves, brain, muscles. Mainly they are having aggravation due to exertion. Easy fatigue is there, anxiety, fear, all neurological complaints. So thank you. Caliphosphoricum. So common name is phosphate of potassium. The name itself suggests Kali is a potassium and phosphoricum is the phosphorus. So common name is the phosphate of potassium. Its formula is K2HPO4. And prover is Dr. H.C. Allen. Even it is proved by Dr. H.C. Allen, it is the one of the best 12 tissue remedy, which were proved by Dr. Schussler. So this is one of the organic tissue salt which is introduced by Dr. Schussler. This medicine has proved by several authorities from time to time, but proving by provers of Union of Chicago under the direction of H.C. Allen is notable. And it contains the phosphorus elements. It is the greatest nerve remedy. So Kaliphos is a nerve remedy. It mainly acts on nerves. Its sphere of action. The main action of this drug is on animal fluids and tissues, mainly on brain, nerves, muscles, and blood cells. So its action is on brain, nerves, muscles, and blood cells. Pathogenesis. As Kaliphos acts upon the brain and nerve cells, upon the corpuscles of blood, affecting the nutrition, it causes irritation. And this irritation is followed by inflammation and lastly to the degeneration. So Kaliphos acts on brain, nerves, blood corpuscles. It affects the nutrition and causes irritation. And irritation is followed by inflammation and lastly to the degeneration. But degeneration is a moderate degree. It is not a syphilitic remedy, so it causes only moderate degree of degeneration. Clinically, it is indicated in anemia, asthma, brain fag, carbuncle, chilblains, dysentery, enuresis, gangrene, hysteria, insomnia, melancholia, neurasthenia, paralysis, and purpural mania. So many clinical diseases, anemia, asthma, brain fag means tiredness of the brain, fatigue of the brain. Patient cannot think anything. Carbuncle, chilblains. Chilblains, these are skin conditions caused due to excessive cold. Dysentery, enuresis. That is, cannot control the urine. Gangrene, hysteria, insomnia, sleeplessness. Melancholia means negative thinking, nervousness. Neurasthenia means they cannot have the sense of pain as it acts on the nerves. Neurasthenia. Paralysis and purpural mania. Purpural mania, purpural is, purpurium period is a 45 days period after delivery. So purpural mania and psychosis during purpural period. And constitution, physical makeup, these are mainly anemic person, chlorotic person, chlorosis. Chlorosis is the old terminology used for the anemia. So anemic, chlorotic, delicate persons, which are worn out from long sufferings. Temperament, this Kaliphos has a nervous temperament. Thermally, these are chilly patients, and miasm is a sora miasm. Ailments from grief, sexual excitement which is indulged or suppressed, causation due to mechanical injuries, causation due to blows. Then mind, they are very nervous. Then the depression of spirit, general irritability. As it has nervous temperament, so mainly nervous people, anxious people. There is a great despondency about business. There is a loss of memory, indisposition to meet people. They don't like to talk with people, even with family also. There is a shyness, disinclined to converse. There's a want of energy, worn out persons. They want energy. The slightest labor seems a very heavy task. There's a brain fag from overwork. They feel that their brain is fatigued. There's anxiety, nervous, dread, lethargy, gloomy moods, fancies. The looks on dark side of everything, negative thinking, melancholia. There's a negative thinking, nervousness. Night terrors with somnambulism. Somnambulism is walking in the sleep. There's extreme lassitude and depression. Hallucinations and illusions of senses. They hear some noises or see something. They fly into a patient and can hardly articulate. There's an aversion to answering the questions. Indifference is there. There's apprehensive anxiety, usually in the evening, in the bed, during night, anxiety after eating, anxiety about future, anxiety about his health. She's very cruel to her baby and husband. She's very indifferent, perverted affections. She broods over her conditions. There's an aversion to company. She wants to be alone. Complaints come from bad news. Like other remedies, complaints from bad news is Epis, Ignatia, Natrum Moor. There's a confusion of mind, low form of delirium, means they talks continuously talking, delirium, usually in typhoid and septic fever. There's imaginations, hallucinations. She sees dead people, sees figures, frightful images. She is discontented. Discontented means unsatisfied. So discontented and sad. He is very excitable, greatly wrought up from bad news. Then follows palpitations and many nervous symptoms. So elements from bad news. There is exhaustion after exertion of mind. There is a fear usually in the evening. Fear of crowd, fear of death, fear of disease, fear of evil, fear of people, and fear of solitude also. Solitude means loneliness. Even if they wants to be live alone, but they are having fear of being alone. He is easily frightened, and this fright increases many nervous symptoms and mental symptoms. There is a weak memory, forgetfulness, cannot recall words. Very good remedy for homesickness. Other remedy for homesickness is the phosphorus. Causation due to effects of grief, prolonged sorrow. There's an indifference to surrounding, indifference to joy, indifference to her family, indifference to his business matters. And after indifference, there's an indolence and lassitude. Then important key notes. Conditions which are arising from want of nerve power, neurasthenia, mental and physical depressions. These are important keynotes. As it acts on nerves, there is a symptoms due to want of nerve power, neurasthenia, sensationless. It corresponds to states of eudaimonia. Eudaimonia is loss of energy. No energy is there. Dynamic. We see that dynamic means energy, power. So there is a loss of power, loss of energy. So state of eudaimonia, decaying conditions, gangrenous conditions. There is a great prostrations runs through this remedy. The discharges are very offensive and putrid. There's a headache, usually of students or those who are worn out by fatigue. Usually right-sided neuralgia, which is relieved by cold applications. So right-sided neuralgia relieved by cold applications. Tongue is coated brownish like mustard color. So mustard color coating over the tongue. Tongue is excessively dry in the morning. There is a nervous gone sensation in the pit of the stomach. Nervous sensation in the stomach. Diarrhea is foul, putrid odor, offensive. Diarrhea is caused due to fright with depression and exhaustion. Menses are too late or too scanty in pale, irritable, sensitive, lachrymose females. Lachrymose females means who cries continuously, crying. Or sadness. In sleep, there's a sleeplessness after worry or after excitement also, or due to nervous causes. There's a somnambulism. Somnambulism is walking in the sleep, usually in the children's. in head. There is a giddiness when they are out of doors. Aggravation when facing sun. So giddiness due to sun exposure. Seasickness without nausea. There is a vertigo with pressure on the brain. Occipital headache, which lasting all night, frequent waking with pain, and better on rising. They woke up with pains in occiput and loins, and which is better by lying on back, and the pain passed off after rising. There is a dull headache across the eyes, which is better at outdoors. Aggravation in the left side, left eyelids, droops with headache. Before menses, there is a violent tearing pain in the forehead with sense of fatigue. So fatigue is the main keynote, fatigue, neurasthenia. So before menses, there is a violent tearing pain in the forehead with sense of fatigue, and which is better by lying down and on menses appearing. There is a pain through base of the brain from eyes to occiput. We have seen the pain from occiput to eyes. In which remedy? It is in cilicia. Occiput to eye. And here the pain travels from eye to occiput. Aggravation in the night, better by eating and gentle motion. Other remedy which is better by gentle motion, it is a sepia. There is a burning pain in the forehead, especially during stools. Intense headache from emotions and physical effort. Headache in the morning on awaking with vomiting of sour phlegm, making eyes unable to bear light. There's a pain across the forehead and into the both temples. Neuralgic pain at the base of brain and upper spine. As it acts on nerves, its important symptom is a pain. Either it is an intense pain or painlessness. So both sides. There's the sensation of band around the forehead, just above the eyes. There's a heavy, dull pain over the eyes as if brain would expand, but for cranial bones. There's a sharp, darting pain over the left orbit, intense itching on the scalp, which is aggravated in the morning after waking. Soreness in the back of the head, which is aggravated by pressure. Back of the head is a sore as if hairs being pulled or as if hair pins are sticking in the head. There is a neuralgia of a left mastoid process, which is aggravated by motion and in the open air. There is itching of the scalp or used in a baldness. And scalp is dry. Then eye complaints. The conjunctiva is inflamed. There is a watery secretion from the eyes. There is a sensation of sticks in the eyes. Sensation of sand in the eyes. Dryness of the eyes. Burning pain. Pricking sensation. Smarting sensation in the eyes. The eyes are full of mucus, which are aggravated in the evening. The lids are swollen, agglutinated in the morning. Sty on the left lower lid. Left lid drops and almost closed. It is ptosis. So used in a condition of ptosis, but left-sided ptosis. We have the remedies for right-sided ptosis also, like staphysaglia, euphorrhea, There's a sharp pain from eyes to temples in the morning, which is better by pressing on the temples. The eyes feel sore around the edges of the lids and burns through they had been full of smoke. The eyes are sore as if crying hard. They awoke with severe pain through the left eye. There's intolerance of light with headache. Eyes are tired with reading. There are black spots moving before the eyes. In ears, there's itching and pimples in the canal and external ears. There's a deep-seated pain in the ears with stinging pain, itching in the ears, and aggravation by lying down. There are sharp pains in the left ear and down to the left cheek. Hearing is too sensitive, cannot endure the noise. In nose, the nostrils are stopped, discharges of clear stringy mucus, obstruction, sneezes on slightest exposure to the air, usually in the 2 a.m., fluent watery coryza, violent sneezing with symptoms of fresh cold. So we can use this remedy in allergic rhinitis. There are sores inside the nares with yellow crust and dark blood. Symptoms of the cold with headache, soft green or white discharge, small growth, very sensitive at opening of the left nostrils, which lasted usually for 2 weeks. Very sensitive to the smell, and sometimes there is a lack of smell. In face, there is a itching under the ear or to the right cheek and temples, itching pimples on forehead and suppurating on next day, neuralgic stitches, especially from upper teeth to the left ear, from temples forward to a point just above the right eye, which is aggravated from cold air and better by warmth of the hand. There are pimples, sore crust on lips, peeling of the lips, soreness and swelling of parotids and axillary glands, red hot burning face and forehead. At other times it is pale and yellow, sickly pale, dirty complexion of these pimples. There is a pain in the jaw bones with stinging and aching, which is better after eating, speaking, walking, and by touch. In teeth, teeth feel sore, severe pains in the deep of filled teeth, the surroundings, gums much swollen. Pain in the teeth after every cold, aching in the teeth with much secretions of saliva, grinding of the teeth, there is a mumbling in the sleep, detox in the sleep, grinding of the teeth during sleep. There is a swelling of gums and upper lip, aching of the teeth all night and forenoon. Gums feel swollen, soft, bleeds easily, dull frontal headache and nausea with dizziness, which is alternating with toothache. In mouth, there is a left submaxillary gland swollen and sensitive. So Kaliphos is a left-sided remedy. All complaints are on left side. Offensive odor from the mouth, mainly in the morning, like a rotten cheese. The tongue is white, slimy, greenish yellow, mustard-like covering on the tongue. The upper surface of the tongue is stiff. The edges are red and sore, red edges and transverse cracks on the tongue. Roof of the mouth is swollen in ridges. fills the lined with a grease. Saliva is a profuse, thick and salty. The mouth tastes badly. There is a bitter taste in the morning, putrid, bitter and sour taste. In throat, tonsils are large, especially left side. There is a dry sensation in the throat as if from husk of grain. So dryness is marked in the throat. In morning, both tonsils have a distinct white solid deposits like diphtheric membranes. There are traces on it on pillars of fossils. There is a severe shooting pain from left tonsil to the inner ear while driving in the forenoon. There is a severe pain in the right tonsils also, which is aggravated by swallowing. There is a soreness, fullness sensation, burning soreness, dryness, which is aggravated mainly in the evening. There is a mucus in the throat, which is much after rising, which causes nausea and which is salty in taste. In stomach, there is a nausea after eating, and after that there is a drowsiness. There is a belching, smelling of sour and bitter food and blood, vomiting of a blood and with palpitation of the heart. There is a eruption of bile, which is aggravated after eating. There is a nausea, which is better by belching. Stool and anus. The stools are clay-colored stools, watery stools, with urging, putrid, offensive flatus, which is followed by tenesmus, which is after breakfast. Tenesmus is a pain in the stomach, cramps in the stomach. Light-colored stools, offensive, unsatisfactory stools, less offensive, which is before 6 a.m. Offensive, undigested, dark-colored stools, which is aggravated after breakfast, after dinner. So diarrhea while eating. In constipation, the stools are dark brown-colored, streaked with yellowish-green mucus. There's aching in the shoulders and arms, better by motion, better in the evening. Hemorrhoids are protruding with swelling and burning pains. Then in respiratory, cough from irritation in the trachea just below the larynx with scanty, thick white mucus, yellowish expectorations, sometimes without expectoration. Cough is aggravated in the 2 to 2:30 a.m., so in the midnight. Sudden unexpected spells preceded by pressure in the throat. There's a hoarseness, trachea feels hurt. There's a rattling or whistling cough where there's expectorations are green like soap suds. Sputa is like salt, fetid or sweet in taste. Yellowish color sputa in thyroid. Thyroid is old terminology for tuberculosis. Then in neck and back, stiff neck from swelling of the glands. Neck is lame, tender to touch. There's aching between scapulae. Stitching pain, which is severe in the middle of the back towards the front of chest with dyspnea, and which is better by leaning against something. Aggravated by lying on back, sitting or walking. They wake up with pains in occiput and loins, which is better by lying on back, and which is passed off after rising. There's a creeping sensation and intense pain along the spine, relieving the headache at intervals. Back is lame as from a fall, sore from shoulders down. In male, there is a nocturnal emissions, sexual power is diminished, impotence and painful emissions at night without erections. There is utter prostration and weak vision after coitus. In females, menses are too late or too scanty. In pale, irritable, sensitive, lacrimose females, irregular, scanty, almost black colored menses, offensive odor, amenorrhea with depression of spirits, lassitude and nervous debility, leucorrhea is yellowish, scalding and which is acrid, acidic. In urinary organs, very yellow urine, there is incontinence of urine from nervous debility, there is enuresis, cannot control the urine, paretic conditions of the bladder, there is bleeding from the urethra. Modalities, there is aggravation by excitement, worry, mental and physical exertion, aggravation in the early morning, amelioration by warmth, by rest, and better by nourishments. So Kaliphos is the main remedy which acts on the nerves, brain, muscles. Mainly they are having aggravation due to exertion. Easy fatigue is there, anxiety, fear, all neurological complaints. So thank you. If any doubt, you can call me or message me personally. Thank you. Send me attendance.